Man is fond of reckoning up his troubles, but he does not count his joys. If he counted them up as he ought, he would find that there is enough happiness in every lot provided for it. Such were the words penned by Fyodor Dostoevsky over 100 years ago in his short magnum opus, PSA De Resistance, his masterwork, Notes from the Underground, although he had many such tour de force magnum opus PSA De Resistance works. What I'm saying is simply this. I believe this, that we need to stop reckoning up our troubles and start instead counting up our joys. Because if we count up our joys, we're going to see, you know what? There is a lot to be grateful for in the here and now, right here. Like my mother, I was raised by incredible parents, my amazing dad, amazing mom. My mom's always teaching me, you're living the dream, you're living the dream, you're living the dream. She's pounding that in my head. So I'm not reckoning up my troubles, but I'm counting up my joys. And I'm like, you know what? There is enough happiness in this lot provided for it. In fact, I am living the dream. And so if I'll soak up this moment and count up my joys, I'll find that there is happiness in every lot. There really is. There really is. If I only will count up my joys. If I'll only count up my joys. So what are you counting up and reckoning up? What are you counting up and reckoning up? Is it your troubles? Or is it your joys? If you count up your joys as you ought, you're going to find that there is enough happiness in every season provided for it. There really is. So whether it's going to the Redwoods, which, by the way, I'm so thankful to Teddy Roosevelt and Benjamin Harrison for allotting these sacred space territories, these national parks, making sure there are national parks where you can't build on them, like they're sacred spaces in America, to allow us to go to the Sequoia National Forest, or whether you're going to Jedediah Smith, or you're floating in the salty Pacific Ocean, or tonight I'm looking at the stars sparkling like sapphires against the inky velvet of interstellar space. Like when I'm looking around at nature, and I'm looking at my friends, and I'm thinking of the accomplishments that the prima causa has given me, I'm so grateful, I'm so thankful, and I find a newfound joy. So in my humble and correct opinion, Dostoevsky is right on the money. Not only was he with Nietzsche alongside Nietzsche, able to predict the upcoming downfall of the 20th century and talk about what would happen if you lived the amoral, you know, ubermensch kind of life in Crime and Punishment, if murder no longer becomes a crime in a mind, but instead you can go against all boundaries of cowardice to have the courage to kill somebody, which is a very inverted way of thinking about things, and then only love redeems the murderer in the end. Like, he not only was able to do that, but he was able to have poignant sayings that helped me so much. Like, he said, if we even got rid of poverty, the problem is the person who's no longer poor, especially through ill-gotten means if we did it, we would find that that person who's no longer poor is now crying that they're not invited to the party. Like, there's always reasons to be sad, whether you're in the plutocracy, aristocracy, or you're in abject poverty, although I absolutely believe we should do everything in our power to destroy abject poverty. It's very difficult to do, but we can do our part individually, at least, regardless of what the, you know, unilateral national decisions might be, or gubernatorial state decisions might be, etc. What I'm saying is, like, there are always reasons for sorrow, but there are also more. I believe there's a multitudinous reason, amount of reasons that we can enjoy joys. Like, we can enjoy the joys, but we have to be able to count them up. So count them up, rack them up. Start thinking about all the joys in your life. Like, really take time to think, maybe I am living the dream. Maybe I'll look back at this season and there's something about it that I'll miss. Maybe there's something about this season that I'll miss. That's not to say there aren't seasons that are just horrific and you just have to survive. Like, I realize that. Sometimes you're living the nightmare. But there's also aspects even in that you're going to look back and say, you know what? I miss this part. I miss that part. So make sure you soak it up now. Soak it up now. Count up your joys more than reckoning up your sorrows, and you're going to find there is more than enough happiness in every lot provided for it. Dostoevsky is right. So with my own little twist on this, I want to encourage you to soak in the blessing of the moment.